A spokesperson for North Korea recently said, should the U.S. miscalculate our patience and light the fuse for a nuclear war, we will surely make the U.S. pay dearly with our mighty nuclear force. That's some pretty scary talk, so let's think about this. What if we had a nuclear war? How would it affect the world as we know it? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobray. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comments below what topics you would like to see next. The Korean Peninsula has seen tense moments before. In 1969, 1994, and 2010. Each time, the world came very close to a nuclear war, but all parties chose to step back. But what if this time, they didn't? North Korea has provoked South Korea before. In 2010, a North Korean torpedo detonated just below a South Korean ship, splitting it into two and killing 46 sailors. That same year, four more people were killed by North Korean artillery. The South Korean president was about to order a counterstrike, but the United States military told him not to. Based on this, we can assume that for a nuclear war to break out, there must be a far more profound provocation. Someone would have to strike first, and that someone would likely be North Korea. The U.S. Intelligence Committee has assessed that North Korea has as many as 60 nuclear warheads. To begin with, North Korea would likely attack the South Korean city of Seoul. They would also launch warheads at the U.S. bases in Japan, Tokyo specifically. That being said, many of those missiles could fall apart mid-flight and not reach their targets. They could also be intercepted by American and South Korean missile defenses, though that is highly improbable. It is highly probable that some of those nuclear warheads could hit their intended targets. Even if they missed the targets by a few miles, these devices are similar to the weapons that destroyed Hiroshima and Nagasaki at the end of World War II. They would affect the surrounding area by up to 10 miles. North Korea would then back up their nuclear attack with conventional missiles and long-range artillery. Thousands would die instantly, others would suffer from radiation sickness. Many would be clinging to life inside the rubble of destroyed buildings. Local hospitals would not be able to provide the amount of medical care needed. Kim Jong-un would not attack the US mainland right away. He would keep his longer-range missiles like the Hwasong 15 for later. He would wait to see if America continued to threaten North Korea. But America would not respond to these strikes by using something like the hydrogen bomb to destroy the whole country. America would respond by launching an air operation to destroy any remaining ballistic missiles and also to kill Kim Jong-un. The United States wants to liberate the people of North Korea, not kill all of them. These airstrikes on North Korean soil would cut Kim off from any communication with his military. Rumors about American nuclear strikes would spread and reach the ear of Kim Jong-un. So Kim would then use his remaining long-range intercontinental ballistic missiles. Based on the map of the United States in Kim's office, he would target San Diego, Pearl Harbor, New York, Washington, and Palm Beach, Florida. Pearl Harbor, because of its close proximity to Asia, would be hit directly. San Diego would get lucky, the ICBM would land in the ocean. Manhattan, which the North Korean state media specifically mentioned as a target, was also hit. If North Korea mounted the hydrogen bomb on its Hwasong 15, everyone in Manhattan would be killed almost instantly. The H-bomb is 10 times more powerful than the atomic bomb that destroyed Hiroshima. The warhead that was intended to hit Washington missed and landed in the Northern Virginia suburbs. The last missile would miss Palm Beach and hit the small town of Jupiter, Florida. Meanwhile, Trump would be hiding out in a bunker, away from Washington somewhere. Kim Jong-un would not have been killed by US air bombers. He would likely commit suicide. The North Korean government would collapse and countless civilians would have been killed by the US air campaign. Millions of New Yorkers would be dead, tens of thousands of people at Pearl Harbor and in Virginia as well. It would take years for the United States to assess the actual death toll, but one can estimate that at least 5 million Americans, South Koreans, and Japanese would die in this war. Well, that's a pretty scary story, isn't it? There is a good reason why there hasn't been an outbreak of war yet. Tensions keep escalating between the United States and North Korea because no one has actually gone and started the war. It could be that the tension will continue to escalate and no shot will be fired for years to come. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobray and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you like this video, you should also check out What If the Hydrogen Bomb Was Dropped on North Korea? Or check out our playlist, Biggest What Ifs. Don't forget to click the bell icon so you never miss an upload.